Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for your always great support. I usually don't take it for granted. Thank you so much. Again, consider liking this video. When you like this video, you automatically support the work that I'm doing in this video. Thank you so much for the like. Now, ladies and gentlemen, regarding Gachagua is coming out to realize that he was used to fight their own people in the mountain. And now he's claiming that him, regarding Gachagua, hata wai piga brother yake vita, hata wai piga sister yake vita. When he's talking about brother and sister, means that hakuna siku atapiga vita kiongozi yeyote ambaye atatoka mountain. And this is whatever regarding Gachagua is saying.
Of purpose for this region.
Yes.
I, regarding Gachagua, will never fight my brother or my sister. We have learned our lessons of division. Other regions are not fighting. People want this region to fight. Ndio tupotee hapo katikati. But why I'm happy today is that the ordinary person from Mount Kenya is united. Lakini, tangu zamani, this region of ours has a history of traitors and betrayals. Kuma hede ya mudhugu, kwa ritukunia, na agati, na komerera, na kudagotome.
So remember, this statement is coming at a time that Rigathi Gachagua has also realized that kuna mabetrayers na traitors. The same thing Uhuru Kenyatta told them. We are having traitors. Hapa kwa wanasiasa hapa, kuna matraitors na betrayers. And so now, Rigathi Gachagua is like vindicating Uhuru Kenyatta's statements. When Uhuru Kenyatta stood firm, seeing that even those who are betraying their fellow leaders, they will find the wrath of betrayal. And this is what Uhuru Kenyatta said.
Sana huku. Hawa ni watu ukiwaongelesha vizuri, mutapelekana na hawa vizuri sana na watawasaidia kwa kazi zenu. Usaliti huko upande mwingine staki sana. Usaliti ni mwingi sana. Lakini kwa wasaliti tunawaambia, hata Judas alisaliti Yesu, lakini hiyo mahela aliiwacha akaenda akatafuta kamba. It is servant leadership.
At the same time, ladies and gentlemen, remember one thing. Regarding Gachagua, and I feel pain as he is now being deserted. Yani everyone is like a bigger percentage of every leader in the mountain. They're trying to distance themselves from regarding Gachagua. But before our eyes, wanaonekana ni kama wanapigania regarding Gachagua. Kupigania regarding Gachagua. Wachana mtai kaiga. Mteka hige umejua ni anaenda kuretire. Second term governor from Nyeri. Where Rigathi Gachagua is coming from. Na sasa anajua akipigania Rigathi Gachagua, kuna kitu watapata hampa mbele. So, he's just fighting for his stomach. Wachana mutai kaiga. So now, Rigathi Gachagua is realizing that is if he's going to fight Ndiri Nyoro, he's going to fight Dennis Itumbi, he's going to fight Anne Waiguru. As when Anne Waiguru is dropping saying this. While we respect the office of the deputy president, and indeed any other office of leadership, a progressive democracy does not allow us, occupiers of public leadership offices, to personalize them to the extent that it becomes taboo for anyone else to nurture and express ambition to occupy them. We hold these offices in trust, not as honors. Let us recognize the right of all, especially our women, and our youth to aspire to high office. Let us hold their hands in mentorship on political and socio-economic leadership. Everyone has a right to dream and pursue their dreams like those in current leadership dreamt and their dreams actualized by the support of millions of youth and women. They too deserve support, not hostility. Hopefully, we all seek the best for Kenya. That is what the statement of Anne Waiguru read. But again, something that, ladies and gentlemen, I want to remind you. Remember one thing. Rigathi Gachagua alikuwa kwa ile team ya William Ruto kufight Uhuru Kenyatta. And so now, he's feeling pain. Yani moyo wake ni mzito sana. As now he's feeling sorry for fighting Uhuru Kenyatta, fighting Mama Ngina. You know, we told them, hakuna vile we nyinyi kabila moja mnalimana. You know, at the same time, you are urging other tribes to unite. But hapa, kuna mtu anawatumia, na ni William Ruto. Remember, William Ruto alipenya mountain katikati kutumia I divide and rule. Divide and rule. Yani anagawanya na anaongoza. Anagawanya na anaongoza. And that is why one thing that he did to ensure he was having elected leaders all over the mountain. And when he succeeded on that, that is how he managed to take the mountain, leaving the mountain divided. But let me tell you, have you realized that William Ruto is so terrified about the unity of the mountain? Have you realized that William Ruto is terrified about the unity of the mountain? Hawataki wa Kikuyu waungane, kwa sababu wanajua, any case, these people will unite themselves. And for them to make resolution against William Ruto, William Ruto, ataonea presidency kwa sap, ataonea presidency kwa viusasa, you will not be re-elected again. But despite of that, William Ruto declared the other time when while in Rwanda, said he was not elected to be re-elected. He was elected to do what he promised Kenyans. So that is what we are waiting, because already, macho ya Rigathi Gachagua imefunguka. Na naona. Hii mtu alikuwa ananidanganya. Na vile ananidanganya, kuna kikundi pale inatoka Rift Valley, wananichimba. Wakijua kwamba, if they are going to fight me, they are going to make someone to arise. And that is why, last Sunday, the close ally of Rigathi Gachagua called Mutahi Kahiga, came out blowing up, that they are not going to accept any kind of let me say blackmailing Rigathi Gachagua, underrating him, undermining him, and they will not accept. So Mutahi Kahiga almost blown up. But at the same time, his close allies are so bitter. Rigathi Gachagua understands the kind of disease, political disease, is suffering from. And already he has realized, requesting for forgiveness and requesting for unity. Why? Because he has realized ile kifua alikuwa nayo during Uhuru Kenyatta's government, si ile kifua itamsaidia sahi mountain. The mountain needs what they promised them. The mountain does not need any fight currently. The same to other regions. Siasa iliisha. But the problem is that kile ambacho ulifanyia mwenzako ndio utafanyiwa. Rigathi Gachagua was so bitter with Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta. So we are so shocked as now he has realized that Uhuru Kenyatta was a gold to him, was a pure gold. And so now fighting Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta was just a big blunder and a big mistake. And Rigathi Gachagua is regretting. Hata ni mtu anatoa machozi ikirudi ndani. So we're just waiting how things are going to be Kenyans, because it is not going to be easy for Rigathi Gachagua. I'm telling you for free. I might not be right, but at the same time, I might be wrong. But remember one thing, I don't think if Rigathi Gachagua is going to succeed easy, because some individuals already, they're so tired with Rigathi Gachagua's politics. Look, have you watched the video of Kinjuri? I've forgotten to look at that video, I'm sorry. Mwangi Kinjuri said that there's some senior government officials, individuals in the mountain, who are trying to play politics. And this politics is dividing them katikati. And that is why they're saying those who are playing politics the way Rigathi Gachagua was trying to play must cool down. So Rigathi Gachagua is cooling down. He must cool down or else he's not going to succeed. And that is the truth. Because akuna vile William Ruto will portray that the mountain to be the way it is, then Rift Valley wako united. Then at the same time, wakati wa Kikuyu wanakutana, wanaambiwa, you people, you are tribal. But wakienda Western, wanaambiwa Western, nyinyi muungane, mukiungana, mutapata kitu hapa mbele. Kikuyus are not fools. So they are just learning slowly by slowly. But remember one thing. These traitors that Uhuru Kenyatta talked about, people like Rigathi Gachagua, akina Ichungwa, Ndini Nyoro, Denis Itumbi, they have realized that the step they are in, or rather the trajectory they are in, is not good. They must change it. That is why they're trying to change the direction so that at least they nature themselves to understand that as one tribe, we should not fight each other, but we must unite ourselves in one cause. So that at least as we are going to fight there, already we are united and they will fear us and they will give us what we want. Ladies and gentlemen, what do you think? Drop your opinion at the comment section below. Otherwise, thank you so much because of your great support. Please consider subscribing, liking, commenting, and sharing this video. Bye-bye till you meet in another video.